2 minute geology. The 2 minute geology. Hello, young people. The Columbia River Basalts near Quincy, Washington. We're at Quincy, Washington, but we could pick any spot between Spokane, Washington and Seaside, Oregon to do this show. These brown layers of basalt are everywhere in the place where the Ice Age floods did massive amounts of erosion thousands of years ago. There's more than 300 layers of basalt here, 300 separate volcanic eruptions, and the stack of basalt is more than 2 miles thick in places. The lavas started erupting 17 million years ago here and flooded a landscape, buried a landscape in lava. The obvious question is, which volcano erupted? Was it Mount Rainier? Mount St. Helens? The answer is none of those. The Cascade Volcanoes do not match the chemistry of these basalt lavas. These are lavas that came from the east. They erupted out of fissures, deep cracks, that emitted Hawaiian-like lava starting 17 million years ago. Fissures that formed related to the birth of a hotspot that's now underneath Yellowstone National Park in Wyoming. The present is the key to the past. To really visualize eastern Washington 17 million years ago, we need to go to Hawaii today. Those Hawaiian lavas today are the same kinds of lavas that we have here. Lava flows in Hawaii, very fluid. The most fluid lavas we have in nature average less than 3 feet thick. Here in eastern Washington, the lava flows average 100 feet thick. In Hawaii, the lavas travel on average 3 miles in length. Here in eastern Washington, many of the lava flows traveled 300 miles. And in Hawaii, 30 miles are covered by a typical flow. Here in eastern Washington, 30,000 square miles of area buried. The Columbia River Basalts near Quincy, Washington. It's all out here to see. Coulees, rocks, and canyons is scenery. Right here for you and me. 2 minute geology.